Hello guys, welcome to part 3 of the creating auto backup system. If you're new here, please consider subscribing. This is the source folder A and this is the destination folder B. This time, instead of xcopy, we are using Robocopy here. Robocopy is the upgraded form of xcopy. Okay, save the bash file with any name, but don't keep the name as Robocopy because it crashes the Robocopy system. Here we have the folder path of the source and this is the folder path of the destination. Type here /e. This can copy all the files including subdirectories and empty directories. Mir can copy all the files including subdirectories and empty directories. Delete destination files and directories that no longer exist in the source. And using the Mir plus E option can overwrite the destination directory security settings. If we delete this t-shirt photo from the source, it can also be deleted from the destination. Let's run the bash file. We can see here the t-shirt photo has been deleted from the destination because it is no longer existing in the source. Delete these files because we wanna test more about copying files. Add here /COPYALL, /ZB, /R:5, /W:8. COPYALL copies file information such as data, attributes, timestamps, NTFS access control list, owner information, and auditing information. ZB copies file in restartable mode. If the access is denied, it switches to backup mode. R5 retries 5 times if runs into any issues. W8 waits for 8 seconds between each of those 5 retries. Right now we are unable to run the bash file because these two, COPYALL and ZB, required to run as administrator. I'll show you how you can give the administrative privileges in the task scheduler part. Run the bash file as administrator. Now it is working. Let's learn how to move files from the source folder to the destination folder. Delete MIR and add MOV. We cannot use MIR with MOV and MOVE, okay? MOV can move the files, but it will leave the source folder and subfolders empty after the files are moved. This can be pretty handy if you have assigned subfolders. MOVE moves the files and subdirectories completely to the destination folder and the source folder gets deleted. First, let's delete files from the destination for the sake of test. We can see here all the files have been moved to the destination, but the source folder gets deleted. So we can fix this. Let's create the folder A back. Put the files back in the source folder. /MOT:1. Using MOT1 together with MOVE can help us to retain only the source after the files are moved to the destination. This can be useful if someone doesn't want to retain files and empty subfolders in the source. The actual function of MOT1 is to monitor the source and run again in 1 minute if changes are detected. Now we are able to return only the source folder after the files have been moved. We can put the files and subdirectories inside the empty source folder whenever we want them to move to the destination folder. Make sure to link the bash file here as we learned in the part 2. Open task scheduler. Create a task here. Give the task name. Now make sure to check this run with highest privileges. Browse for the VBS file. Cut this and paste it down. Type here wscript.exe. That's it. Hope this helps you guys. Thanks for watching. Stay technically sound and spread love and compassion to all.